Picasso, guitars, 1912 to 1914. My essential collaborator in this project was Blair Hartzell, curatorial assistant, and over there. This is an exhibition that set out to situate, to sort of position, to try to better understand Picasso's two remarkable guitar constructions, one made from paper, string, and cardboard, and the other one from sheet metal, within the larger context of his studio practice between 1912 and 1914. We chose to look at this moment in his work not so much for what it could tell us about his style or about an ism known as cubism, but rather for what we could learn, what it revealed about Picasso's creative process at this very particular moment during this absolutely explosive period of material and structural and spatial experimentation. I hope very much as you walk around the gallery and look at the work on view that you'll see this radically simple vocabulary of shapes and forms that Picasso combines and recombines to make all sorts of different things. Not just guitars, but you'll see bottles and heads and tabletops and violins, right, and wine glasses cobbled together. This has been a word of discussion. I don't know where you are, Jerry Oyner. Conjured up, shall we say, perhaps better, from these absolutely unprecedented combinations of traditional fine art supplies and common, everyday materials, newspaper, wallpaper, and sheet music. Picasso's methods during this period also range tremendously widely from everything from these crude, really, craft techniques, you know, cutting, pasting, pinning, and folding, to artisanal tricks, like those used to imitate, as you'll see in many works in the show, those used to imitate in paint expensive materials like wood or marble, to, on the other hand, absolutely exquisite passages of line and shape and color and form. And we hope so very much that what everybody takes away from this is a sense of the absolute kind of exuberant heterogeneity of the works during this period, this irreverent mixing and matching, the constant back and forth as you look between two dimensions and three. I think there's just sort of a world of possibilities in this room that was left for 20th century artists to build upon in countless different ways. I mean, if you think about it, collage, constructed relief sculpture, mixed media painting, the use of found materials, seriality, or repetition and variation as generative strategies, the idea that you can invent a vocabulary of signs and forms so simple that they approach the brink of abstraction, but depending on their position in relation to each other, always retain a residue of resemblance. I think all of that is in evidence in the works in this room. I should say that we have left the plan of the gallery deliberately open because we did very much, as Glenn said, we wanted everybody to be able to experience works both individually and then in relation to each other, as they might, in fact, in an artist studio where things tend to happen sort of all at once in relation to each other rather than in some neat linear path. I hope some of you also noticed walking up to the show that we've lined the entry hall as you approach the exhibition with impressions from visitors to Picasso's studio between 1912 and 1914, both to capture a sense for us of the profound excitement that these works on view here generated for those who first saw them, and to encourage you, and then of course the museum's larger contemporary audience, to sort of try, you know, to think of yourselves as somehow akin to those incredibly lucky early visitors who first stepped over that threshold into Picasso's studio almost a century ago to discover, as the critic and raconteur André Salmon so memorably put it, things no one had ever seen before. And so that's what we're hoping we're presenting for you.